We continue to battle historic wildfires, but we're also battling this historic pandemic, COVID-19, that has not gone away. That makes some of our wildfire efforts a little bit more challenging, but we are up to the task. We have prepared new protocols, processes, and procedures in anticipation of meeting this moment. We had highlighted and socialized a number of those strategies a number of months ago when we highlighted a supplemental appropriation to get some 858 new CAL FIRE personnel hired, 830 that already now are out on the lines. But we had put together new sheltering protocols. We put together new protocols in terms of taking care of our first responders as well. Let me give you just a brief example of some of those efforts. We now have health screening that is done, an assessment before entry in any of our congregate shelters throughout our systems, part and parcel of the evacuation protocols. We have mask requirements, social distancing. You'll see not just, you see cots and mats, but not just cots and mats any longer. You'll see tents inside of these facilities that allow us to cohort families and individuals so that they can be more appropriately socially distanced as well as physically distanced from others in these congregate facilities. Also getting as many air purifiers as we can. I want to thank our partners at CARB and others, Bay Area Air Quality Management District, that have been working overtime to get more air purifiers into these shelters. We still have work to do in that space, but progress has been made. But no longer are we just bringing people into congregate facilities. We're also bringing people into non-congregate settings. In fact, the majority of people that have been evacuated are no longer being evacuated into those congregate shelters. They're being evacuated into hotels. We now have 31 hotels, close to 1,500 people that are in those hotel rooms. This is part and parcel of what we built off of through the pandemic. We built new protocols to process these pandemic protocols into our evacuation protocols for these wildfires. In addition, though, of course, to the non-congregate shelters, we do have more traditional shelters in seven counties, 17 specific shelters, about 731 people in those shelters, but over 2,211 evacuees as of this morning in our shelter system. Many more that have been evacuated, including into trailer parks. I visited one of those trailer parks in the Santa Cruz area yesterday, and others with family, with friends that may be in need of shelters. So we continue to build our capacity, to build our protocols in terms of procuring more hotel rooms to provide as many people access in a timely way that we possibly can. Look, speaking of timely, it is, of course, always timely to remind everybody of the challenges we continue to face in terms of the pandemic itself and the case numbers related to COVID-19.